This AI model will change everything. Out of nowhere came a company called Black Forest Labs, and they released Flux. And it's everything we expected from Stable Diffusion 3. 14 of the 15 employees of Black Forest Labs are former Stability AI employees, the creators behind Stable Diffusion. The prompt adherence is amazing, the outputs are great. Flux is amazing at creating text, and you can render high resolution images from the start. It comes in three flavors: Pro, Dev, and Schnell. Schnell means fast in German. Before you download anything, you can try it out on this page. Up here, enter your image prompt. We try photorealistic image of a ninja character in mid-air, seemingly jumping between buildings in an urban environment of New York. Press run. This render took about 15 seconds. I think it's a great start. I will show you later how we can improve on it. Down here, you also have advanced settings. You can change the width and the height, or you can increase or decrease the amount of steps. 4 to 8 are good values for the Schnell model. If you want to use the dev version, click up here and type dev, hit enter. To use it, you need a running ComfUI or Stable Swarm installation. You can find videos on how to install them here and here. We need to download the model, which is 24 GB in size. If you want to use the dev version instead, scroll up. Click here, then scroll down again and click on dev. You have to have a Hugging Face account and you also need to sign an agreement to use it. Now we need our text encoders. Download the clip L and you need to download one of these. I suggest you try the 16-bit version first, and if your PC can't handle it, then use the 8-bit version. I will show you a few tricks later on how you can run it on an older hardware. To decode and encode our image, we need the VAE. I downloaded it and renamed it to Flux Schnell VAE. We need the workflow itself, so go to this URL and scroll down. Do a right click on this image with the bottle. Click Save As. Don't just make a screenshot. In your ComfUI root folder, you click on ComfUI. Then on Models, and you put the 24 GB file in the UNet folder. The clip L and the T5XXL go into the clip folder, not the clip vision folder. The VAE has to go into the VAE folder, obviously. Also make sure that your ComfUI is up to date. Click on Manager and then click Update All. After everything's installed, hit the Restart button. This again can take a while. Back in ComfUI, drag and drop the image in we downloaded earlier. It should look like this. Up here we have our Flux Schnell model. Click on these arrow icons here, and if UNet name says undefined, then your model's in the wrong folder. Unless you have a graphics card with 24 GB VRAM, you want to use the FP8 weight here. Because if not, your PC can freeze and it can take a couple of minutes to get a single image. Later I will show you another great performance tip. For the dual clip loader, we choose our T5XXL 16FP and our clip L. I already have them from Stable Diffusion 3, so mine's named a little bit differently. Just to demonstrate, if I click Q now, I get an error. If you get an error message like this and a red box, that means ComfUI is unable to find your VAE. As I told you, I have renamed it to Flux Schnell, and that's what I'm going to pick here. Before I explain further, let's test render. It looks great. The first time it renders, it can take a little bit longer. That's because the model needs to be loaded in your RAM or VRAM. After that, it's cached. There are two things that are different from a regular Stable Diffusion workflow. First, we have no negative prompt box. And currently there is no CFG scale, but we will build it in now. Double click on an empty space and type flux. Then select Flux Guidance. The way this works is our clip encoder is transforming our prompt into a conditioning for our model. A low value means more creative freedom for the AI, and a higher value means that it should stick more to your prompt. Let's connect it by click on the orange dot and drag it over to the conditioning input and let it go. By connecting the guidance output with the basic guider, we automatically disconnect the basic guider from the clip text encode. Let's explore the workflow further. Here you can set up the width and the height, and also how many images you want to render at the same time. Max resolution is 248 by 248. But spoiler alert, it will take about 5 minutes to render a single image. Down here you can select our sampler and our scheduler. Reddit user Gerold Meisinger compared different sampler and scheduler against each other, but to be honest, the difference in flux is more subtle than in stable diffusion apparently. So I usually use Euler simple or Euler normal. If you want to know more about how schedulers and samplers work, watch this video here, where I explain it in detail. Oh, how did that get in here? I have no idea. But a more important note is the sampler custom advanced. In a classic stable diffusion workflow, that would have been the case sampler. Let's remove it again. The VAE decoder decodes our image from a latent space into a pixel space where we can see it. One thing we forgot to talk about is the steps. Steps is how many iteration an image needs from start to finish. What makes the Schnell model so fast is that it only needs 4 steps. If you're using the Dev model, you should use a minimum of 20 steps. Let's write a prompt of our own. How about a stunning cinematic movie still showing an orc warrior in full armor. He wears a leather belt that is fully equipped with potions and runes. He storms into battle, striking an epic fight pose. With Flux you can use a much more descriptive approach instead of just using keywords like in stable diffusion. Let's fix this typo here. For the render style I will stick to the old keyword approach. So I want it to be a 35mm photograph, film, bokeh, professional, 4K and highly detailed. Let's change the image height to 1280. Now we click here on extra options and batch count 4. Now click queue prompt. Let's see where this leads us. Don't forget, the initial render will take longer. So apparently the Schnell version does not look how an orc looks like. Let's see how we can help Flux through clever prompting. To not bore you with my slow typing, I modified the prompt off camera. I described the scene as a medieval fantasy setting and the creature has dark green skin and has sharp pointy ears. Often good prompting is better than using Alora. And I added Warhammer Universe down here, but I don't know that Flux knows what that is, but maybe it helps. We render again 4 images. Amazing, I'm impressed with all the details and remember, this is just the Schnell model. Imagine what the Dev or the Pro version could do. Now we will increase the details of the image so that it looks more like this. But before, if your PC freezes and you have an Nvidia card, then open your Nvidia control panel. Here, click on Manage 3D Settings. And here where it says CUDA System Fallback Policy, click on Driver Default and select Prefer No System Fallback. Now your system will prefer the VRAM over your normal RAM. Don't forget to hit the Apply button. For this to work properly, you might want to restart ComfyUI. Some of you may not like this, but we are going to use SDXL for this. Look at this image. This was my initial render of an alternate Last of Us box art. And Flux does not know who Ellie and Joel are because it gave me these two random people here. So after my upscale, it destroyed the logo a little bit here, but now you can clearly recognize Ellie and this could be Joel. So I think SDXL for upscaling can be great. Since we are not changing between SDXL models, we have to use the image output. Otherwise we would grab the latent. So I grab it, I let it go here and I select VAE encode. So basically the image gets decoded into a pixelated image and now we are encoding it again. For this we need a VAE. So we drag the VAE, let it go here, and we select VAE loader. So now you should have this box here. From the dropdown, select your SDXL VAE. If you don't have one, download it from here. I put the link in the video description. We are going to drag the latent here and we say case sampler. The case sampler is basically the same as this up here. And this here, so it's just integrated here. Maybe there will be an updated version for Flux as well. So down here, we will continue to do the same thing. We are going to drag it back and forth, basically. So now we are dragging the model and we say checkpoint loader simple. We need a positive and negative prompt box, which we drag from here. We say clip text encode, and we do this twice. A lot of people color the boxes. So for the positive prompt, they go with green. And for the negative prompt, they go with red. Just do a right click and say colors and select red. Now what we have to do is we have to connect our clips with the checkpoint loader. Now I'm scrolling up and I copy paste the prompt. Copy, scroll down, paste. So for negative prompt, we won't leave it empty. Instead, I have my default prompt. You can find this on my Patreon, by the way, for free. I have a whole style collection for SDXL and 1.5 for you. Maybe I will make one for Flux as well. Okay, I see we made a mistake. We put the latent in here, but we need to upscale it. So that means we make a double click in an empty space and type upscale latent by. So with this, we can say we want the image size we have and we upscale it by 1.5. So the width and the height gets multiplied basically. I connect it and I connect the latent image with this. So the other line gets removed and we have a clear connection here. It should look like this for you. I prefer this to fixed values because it keeps the aspect ratio. So the case sampler gives us a latent image. So we have to decode the image again. So we drag the latent here and we say VAE decode. So the VAE decode needs to be connected with our VAE again. So we click and drag it here. Okay, last, we need to drag the image node here and let it go and say save image. So this should work. We need to do some tinkering here. Let's go with 25 steps. I often like a CFG of 7. Sampler name, we are using DPM++2M. And before scheduler, we take Keras. So denoise, this is important. We go by 0.4. So you can try out values down to 0.2. It will almost make no changes and you can go up to 0.6. But 0.6 could be too much actually. So let's cue it and see. So this is our image we already know. And let's go down here. It loads our model, takes our clip into account, the VAE, and now it upscales the image, hopefully. And as you can see, it looks terrible. So 1.75 may a little bit hype. What I did now is I changed the scale to 1.5 and I made sure that both are using the same seed. So I copied the seed here. I set it to increment and I did the same as well up here. So copy paste it and here I set it to increment. Ah, much better. So if you think too much has changed now, you can reduce the denoising strength and render with the previous seed again. But I like it very much. I like all the details and the hair details. It looks much more realistic. There are many more upscale techniques I can teach you. For this video was meant to be a basic tutorial, so we are going to leave it as is. If you want to learn how to upscale properly in Automatic 1111, then watch this video next.